us my channel. My name is Iyanoluwa. Thank you for tuning into my channel. And if you are new here, you're welcome. I've not been greeting the newcomers. So if you are new here, you're welcome. Welcome to Real Kitchen and Pastries. So I'm very sorry, guys. You guys must have been waiting for my video last week. I couldn't upload any video because I was busy. So this week, I decided to make something tiwa tiwa, something local. So I'm making akara and pap, akara with pap, that yellow pap. I don't know what they call it, agbado yellow or something. So I'm making akara with pap. So if you want to make akara, you don't make the beans to be 2 or 3. You know, why blending it? It should not be 2 or 3. So by the time you put it in the hot oil, it will form. And secondly, when you are adding salt to your beans, it should be small salt, little salt, not like the quantity you had to your moi moi. And again, if you want the oil or the palm oil, you want to use the vegetable oil or the palm oil, should be plenty, so your akara will be able to float in the oil. So those are the little mistakes that we don't really take note of. And let me take you guys to my kitchen to see what we can do. So this is the beans. So I just blended the beans now, and I'm going to be adding roto. This is pepper. So this is the pepper. I'll be adding it to the beans. Just add small. I'm going to use the pepper. So I'll be mixing it together. If the beans is actually more than this, you can make use of turning stick. This is turning stick. We call it a moroku in Yoruba. But I won't be needing a moroku for this, just small beans. So I have sliced onion here. So I'll be adding the sliced onion. I forgot to mention it. When I was blending the beans, I blended it with some onions, like medium size too. So it's not just beans that was there, it's beans and onion. And I also added sliced onion to it. So if you want to make akara, you don't just add the amount of maggi or salt that you always add to your moi moi. If I want to make akara, I always add just salt. I don't add maggi to my akara. I add salt, and just little salt, just little, because if you add plenty, trust me, akara will be so salty. So just little salt is what we are adding. So you don't make it too watery. So when you are frying it, it will be able to foam. You just mix it the way you mix your egusi when you want to make your egusi. So this is it. I hope you guys can see it. So you can see the way I'm actually mixing it. It's not too thick and it's not too watery. So I don't add Maggi to my akara, as I've said earlier, and that's it. Just and now I'm making pap. So you mix the ogi with water. So you mix it very well. And after mixing it like this, I'm actually boiling water. So the hot water is what you're going to pour inside. And yeah, it will be ready. If you want to add sugar, you add sugar. If you want to add honey, you add honey when it's done. Method means the oil is going to be much, going to be plenty. So you can see the quantity of oil I'm making use of to fry the akara.
Guys, thank you for watching my video. If you like it, click on the like button. Kindly share my video with your friends and family, and remember to subscribe to my channel. See you guys next week. Bye.